All right, good morning, everyone. It's the AM Icebreaker for April, Friday the 13th. Oh, God. I wonder what horrible things we're going to find out about today. I guess if some people were to be believed, the world is ending again. But I don't know. I'm having a good week, even though it's gray and rainy in Seattle, and I'm a little worn out from wrestling, but it's good. Does any of you guys, ever roll like a BJJ player? Do you guys ever roll with the heavyweights? Man, I tell you what, there's this one guy that I just love rolling with. He's probably the biggest, strongest dude in our gym. And trying to move this guy is like trying to move a sack of wet cement and bricks and cannonballs and pieces of neutron star. But, it's such great training for me, though. And I think, head-wise, it's good because I'm used to being, one of the bigger, stronger guys. And it's like I said, I think I talked about this a little while ago. It's actually, not be that and have people who are just physically who are just more imposing to work against is really good for me. Really good for me, really healthy. It gives me a good perspective, and there's some other issues it really helps me with too, but I'm not gonna go into those here. But I hope everybody had a great week. Hope everybody's got some great plans for the weekend. I've got a pretty busy weekend myself. Actually, one of the things I want to talk about is I'm putting together a webinar called Everyday Breathwork. And I'm going to offer it to anybody who's watching this video. Hit me up, just comment either on YouTube or Facebook that you want to be added, and I will add you to the group. And it's going to be sometime in the next couple of weeks. I haven't set a firm date yet, but it's going to happen very soon. I'm actually just finishing up the content this week, and I'm really excited. It's gonna kind of dovetail with some of the stuff that I talked about in my GDC talk, and we'll do a quick overview of that at least probably in another video just for people who want some context. I'll probably post something in there's a Facebook group that I'll add people to, and we'll talk about some things there. But it's nothing like super technical, super anatomy. Like you don't have to be. I mean, like I said, it's called Everyday Breathwork for a specific reason. It's because it's like my GDC talk. My GDC talk. Yeah, I went a little deep, but it was just. Everyday joint health and mobility for people who spend way too much time sitting at a desk. And since we all need to breathe, and I don't want to go too deep into the specifics. As much as I love that stuff, I know what I want to give people is actionable stuff. So today, leading up to a bunch of things, I know I keep saying this ego thing, but I actually wanted to share some of the comments I got from yesterday. I asked people to post some motivational quotes. And you guys, I really, really appreciate it when you interact and participate. I love that, this is a conversation. I mean, some of you guys know a big part of my day job involves, working with people in interaction design. So I love to interact. I don't like to just be the guy who's just, kind of vomiting, information out of people. I like people to stop me and redirect and offer their own thoughts, even if they're contrary thoughts. Honestly, if it's a well-presented contrary thought, I'm happy to talk about it. I'm not one of these people who shies away from a good from a good little breaching of idea or meeting of ideas. I mean I don't appreciate when things are just kind of nasty and unproductive, or when people just are like so set on their argument. I posted something on my Facebook the other day about this whole, all this Facebook stuff, and at the very end of the conversation, I think the person I was talking to said something to the effect of, well, nothing good can come of this because capitalism and all those other C words that people just love to throw out that are the downfall of Western civilization. If your stance is basically just like, nope, I'm convinced that's it, this is it, it's like, all right, well, we don't really need to talk. Anyway, that was very long-winded and unnecessary. So let's get right to the cool stuff. Let's get to the positive uplifting stuff. First off, from my buddy Andres, and I've talked about Andres before. We did Kajikembo together for a while, and he's turned into quite a jiu-jitsu player. And actually, he's one of the things that keeps me kind of on the mats, just because I've literally watched this guy grow. I've watched his whole jiu-jitsu path, and to see where he started and where he is now is super, super inspiring, to me, because he's like the rest of us. He's just a guy who loves jiu-jitsu and, has a family and has a job and trains the way he can when he can and loves doing it. And so he said some interesting things. And the thing that I like that he said best is a C.T. Fletcher thing. You guys who know C.T. Fletcher, C.T. Fletcher has those great videos where he talks about commanding your muscles to grow. So, I command you to grow. And so, and he said, well, that, and he said, that's one of his motivational quotes is, I command you to. And I know there are some people who think like, oh no, you shouldn't, you know, there's this thing about negative self-talk, but I think we've started to kind of like almost go too far down that, like where everything is negative self-talk, unless it's just like this overwhelmingly positive. And, you know, sometimes I think it's okay. You know, I like that idea of I command you to, because sometimes it's in you, you know. In fact, a lot of times I'll say like, that next rep is in you, that next kind of role is in you, that, you know, that just holding on for that one more thing is in you. But, you know, we kind of want to peter out early, and I'm the worst about this, I'll admit it. Like, as my jiu-jitsu coach, I mean the one thing he like gives me shit about for all the time is quitting early, which, you know, I'll admit there's times I do it, but I think having that little kind of that little push in your ear that I command you to, where it's like, no, like just do it, you know. And that's kind of cool, because it leads into a quote from my buddy Brad, Clark, Reading Dojo. I think we've talked about the upcoming course with that, which I'm actually wrapping up the first part of, which is desk mobility, desk workouts. But Brad said one of Brad's quotes was, one more time, which I think is very much like, I commend you, and I agree, like, one more time again, especially like if you're not quite feeling it, but you, again, you know you can, or there's that other voice that's like, I bet we could, you know. And you're not, and obviously, like, you know, you if you've self-assessed, you're like, well, I'm not like dying, I'm not hurting, I'm not injured, I'm not on my way to an injury. It's like, I could do one more. So one more time, I'm with that. And then he brought this other great quote, and I love this one from one of his instructors. And the quote is, if you're running and tired, your brain says walk. If you walk, you will want to sit. You will want to lay down. You lay down, you die. So if you feel like you want to lay down, stand up. Stand up, then walk. If you are walking, then tell yourself to run. Keep going, never give up. I love that. You know, it's because kind of like something we talked about the other day. We talked about that shifting perspective, right? It's like, you know, it's like, well, look at where you are. And like, well, how can I change this? How can I make this better? Oh, well, you know, I don't always have to go backwards. I can go forward. You know, I think that's another thing that I'd like to talk about at some point. This idea that I feel like we almost get stuck in this kind of in this, like, well, I, you know, this is where I am. This is the best it's going to get. You know, there's no moving forward. I mean, that's a long conversation. You guys get kind of what I'm saying, but I like that other mentality. I like that mentality of like, no, let's move forward. Let's get up. Let's go up to that next tier. And that actually kind of reminds me of something. I think Rogan says it. He's, you know, I think he got it from some, I'm not sure where he got it from. But basically, it's, and you guys have heard it if you watch the GRE. He says, you know, when your brain says quit, your body is probably only at about 40%. It's probably only about 40% done. And obviously, like, that's just an arbitrary number, but you get the idea, right? And I think that's something we can all kind of relate to, especially, like, you know, I'm sure, you know, if you watch this, you're probably a hard trainer, and there's probably times, like, let's be honest, there's probably times where you've just kind of been like, I just don't wanna, but I know I could, but you know you could, like, you're not really tired, it's just your brain is just lazy, right? So, great quotes, everybody, and like I said, I like how they all kind of, like, sort of tie together, you know, right now. I mean, I like that, you know, people are on the same wavelength, and they're all, and we're all thinking the same thing, and honestly, like, you know, Brad and Andres, like, you know, you guys are probably two of the hardest training, like, I don't mean this as an insult, but you guys are probably, like, just the hardest training, like, you know, normal guys that I know, just like me, right? Like, we're all just, like, guys who are, like, just living our lives, and we have jobs, and we have families, and we have social lives, but we also, like, love to train, and, you know, and we do, and, you know, and hopefully, I don't know, like I said, guys like you, you know, you guys keep me going, and, you know, that's another admonition to folks. I mean, find your... You know, find your heroes out there, you know, people who are doing the thing you're doing that you want to do, that can kind of keep you going, you know, that can kind of hold you accountable, even if not directly, even if it's just people that you look at and say, oh man, that guy's training today, I got to go train too. So anyway, that's what I got for today. Everybody have a good weekend, and cheers.